Hello, I'm Dr. Israel Barkin, the Medical Director of the Prostate Cancer Research and Education Foundation. I would like to wish all of you a Happy New Year and the best of health. I found it appropriate to bring to you an answer to a question, and the question is, what are the MEDS principles? This is a question that was on Ask Dr. Barkin call-in show, so I brought the clip discussing what are the letters MEDS, what do they mean? I use this principle when I do coaching for patients, and I find it useful to put things in the right frame of mind. I'll tell you right now, the MEDS is not medication, it stands for something else. So let's go now to the clip about MEDS. Enjoy the viewing.
Hi, Dr. Barkin. This is James from Texas. I went to your website, pcres.org, and I read the section about the MEDS, M-E-D-S, principles. Can you explain how to use these principles? I am pretty new to prostate cancer, and I want to make some diet and lifestyle changes. Thank you.
The MEDS, the four letters M-E-D-S, stand for M stand for mental attitude, E stand for exercise, D stand for diet, and S stand for spirituality. I always tell patients, before you ask yourself what a doctor could do for you, you should ask yourself, what can I do for myself, to help my doctor, to help me, in that order. So as such, the letter M stands for mental attitude. Mental attitude means that you don't have to be afraid of dying, you have to get busy being alive. I'm always surprised with people, in spite of their advanced age, they never function according to what their inner little voice is telling them. They do what their wife tells them, what the doctor tells them, what the neighbors tell them. They play the game, follow the leader, instead of really asking themselves from the inside, what do I feel comfortable, what is the right decision for me? So that's the mental attitude, which is very, very important. And I always say that there is the 11th commandment beside the 10th commandment. The 10th commandment always deal with you as a patient and somebody else. You and your neighbor, you and your parents, you and God, you and somebody else. But be truthful to thyself is the most important commandment, because only then you'll be a happy person. Only then you'll make the right decision for yourself. So this is the mental attitude. The exercise, very briefly, I would like to go over. It's not only the cardiovascular exercise you need to do. Besides walking or running or swimming, which is good for the cardiovascular, you need to do resistance exercise and exercise your muscles. On the D is the diet program that we cannot get now into it. There is one book I strongly recommend by Dr. Moyad. It's called The ABC of Nutrition. The S is spirituality, and my spirituality is very simple. Is be very nice to the people very close to you. Be 10 times nicer to them. Don't try to save the universe and humanity and neglect the people that are very close to you. It's extremely powerful when we are very spiritual and very supporting of our close to our heart, wife, children, and friend and family. Then it's extremely powerful. You have the strength to go through everything, because then you have a meaning to your life, because then you know why are you doing it, and you get a lot of support. James, I hope you are still on the line, and let's see if you have any follow-up questions. All I would say is that if you want, we have an article about the subject, the MEDS principle. Let's go now to James.
Hello, Dr. Barkin.
Hi, James. Thank you so much for asking this very important question.
Well, thank you for the call-in show and for your answer. I really appreciate it, and I'm going to apply all the MEDS principles.
Okay, so stay in touch with us and join us every Tuesday, and I wish you the best.
Thank you.
Okay, good night. To learn more about the MEDS principle, please join us on askdrbarkin.wordpress.com. Enjoy.